Hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder match. Yep, that's right, we're taking a look at a replay this time with post-commentary. And that's because I screwed up the recording. I started the recording at the beginning of the match and then immediately went to type something to somebody and accidentally stopped the recording, which obviously I didn't notice until about halfway through the match, then started the recording again, then said, you know what, it's not worth it, I already missed half the match, then stopped the recording again and then realized I missed a whole bunch of other stuff. So, it's not IS6, we still have about 16 more IS6 videos to upload anyways, but somebody asked me if I wanted to squad up, and I said, yeah, sure, and so they chose to play 4.7 Russians, and I was like, okay, yeah, let's do it. I hadn't played this battle rating for the Russians in quite some time, so I loaded it up, and here we go. So we're on the Ash River map, the new version of the map, and I am driving the T-34-57 Mod 1943, the premium T-34-57. Very, very fun tank indeed. So I'm coming up here to this vantage point because, well, I don't really want to move up on the map too much. We're fighting the United States and the British this time around. It's just the Russians versus those nations. Have barely seen the Germans in our entire session today that we played, which we played about like 4 or 5, maybe 6 matches, somewhere around there. I think we only saw the Germans once, and they were on our team. I kind of wish we were fighting the Germans, honestly, because then you don't have to worry about fighting Sherman Jumbos. Thankfully, though, I'm not going to have to worry about a Sherman Jumbo in this match, so let's go ahead and continue. So I'm just sitting here. I've got an ASU-57 here with me, and a KV-1 behind me, I believe, is coming up on the hill as well. I'm looking for things. Nothing's driving out across, but I can see shells or something coming in from up there on their side for their vantage point. Didn't see anything, so was unable to actually shoot at anything. My squad mate is down there. Unfortunately, I don't think you can actually see him in the replay system. He's down there somewhere. I just called in artillery on their vantage point, and I can see something's getting hit over there. Somebody fired off a smoke shell. I don't know if that was the enemy or if that was the KV, I'm not sure where that smoke came from. So I'm still just waiting. Here we got teammates right there to the left. That would be my squad mate, that T-34 that started popping out. Still nothing. Nothing to shoot at, which I was quite surprised by. Usually every time I come up here, there's something to shoot at. But then a shell comes in, and I start shooting my machine guns. Don't know where it's coming from. I see it right there. I blind fire. And I end up hitting the front of, yeah, that's a Churchill Mark 7, right? I believe it's a Churchill Mark 7. And Churchill Mark 7s are a lot more armored than the Churchill Mark 3. And now if that was a Churchill Mark 3, I would have gone straight through the front of his turret and probably knocked out a crew member or two. This gun is very high velocity, and it does have a lot of penetration on its shell. But it's apparently not enough to go through the front of a Churchill Mark 7, which is why I'm usually afraid when I see them in most of my tanks. So still waiting. There's something else over there shooting. Can't see it yet. That Churchill is still over there. He's pulled back, I believe. No, he's still there. I put another shot. I think that went over. Fired a little bit too high. I pulled back. Look again. Still nothing. Pop out again. Is he there? I'm not sure. I don't see him. I'm trying to look, but I don't see him. And so far, I'm of no use here. I've done absolutely nothing. I've hit one tank, and it was a non-penetrating shot. We've got teammates still down there, but nothing is actually working out right now. My squad mate is still alive down there in his T-34-57 Mod 1943. I'm waiting. That was not my artillery. That was somebody else's artillery, but nothing. So I decide to reposition. Now, one of my favorite areas to sit on this map is right there over this rock wall. Unfortunately, though, getting there in a T-34 is a little bit harder than in just about any other tank. And this is kind of where the physics of War Thunder start to fail. So I'm trying to get up over this rock, and instead of it actually pushing up over it, you start to basically, you kind of blend, you melt into the rock, and you start sliding around really unrealistically. Now I'm trying to, what I'm trying to do now is I'm smashing into this boulder and I'm trying to turn myself very slowly, but this isn't the annoying part. I mean, you can see how my tracks and suspension are melting through the rock. That's a problem because you will actually get stuck. So as you can see, it's pulling me to the right even though I'm not turning. And this rock right here, right in front of my right track, is the problem. Watch this. I get stuck on it. And so I have to pull back, and I'm trying to angle so that I don't hit it. And watch, I get stuck on it, and it just pulls my tank that way. And now I can't move my turret. Did you see for that second? I can't move my turret, still can't. Because it thinks I'm getting stuck. And when you're stuck, you can't move your turret, which is really annoying. So I'm up here at a really weird-ass angle. There's smoke down there. There's got to be some kind of enemies. And there is. Two things. Now, I thought that was actually a Sherman Jumbo at first, which is why I didn't shoot at him, and instead went for the Churchill Mark III, or a 3-inch gun carrier, rather. First shot knocked his driver out, second shot finished off two more of his crew, knocking him out. And then I come around again, I can see that he is not focused on me, that other tank down there, and then I realize, oh, it's not a jumbo, it's actually a ram. And so I put a shot through, and I believe it knocks out his driver, his two front crew members. I wait, I aim, another shot through, and finishes off the rest of his crew. So there you go, that puts me up to two kills, and now I'm actually being useful. I saw a shell coming from this direction, and you can see right there, there's the top of an Avenger's turret. Now, I tried to shoot, but the moment I shot, he moved, and my shell missed. I don't think he knows that I'm here, but, well, he definitely knows something's shooting at him now. I just ricocheted off the top of his turret there. And then we have this guy. Now, I can't tell, is this an M10 or an Achilles? I'm not exactly sure. It's one of the two, but first shot knocks his engine out, second shot knocks his driver out, and I'm trying to finish this guy off. That shot goes in, goes straight through, doesn't really do anything. Then there's another one down there, you can see, right there. That's an M10, I believe. Well, it might still be... Nope, that's just an M10. I fire him, he knows I'm here, he shoots, and it doesn't do any damage, besides slight damage. Finish him off... Yeah, that is an M10. Finish him off, so that's good. That was lucky there, because he knew I was there. And then, bam, I take a hit. Driver and, I believe, loader have been knocked out by that Avenger. And so I now have to reload. He fires again. This one doesn't penetrate. I shoot randomly, thinking he was there, and he was, and I kill the Avenger. That's five kills, because that other tank destroyer burned up all while that was going on. I thought that was the end of my journey, but it wasn't. I got pretty lucky there with that Avenger. I think that was an Avenger, I hope. So I keep poking out, and we've got, I believe those were teammates moving across the field there. And I start pulling back again, and then out the corner of my eye, I see something moving. This isn't teammate. Oh, it's a Sherman Jumbo. I knock out two of his crew members in his turret, but then he drives off behind the rock. And I probably shouldn't have done that, because if he knew I was here, that would have been the end of my run, for sure. I notice something else down there. It's a Sherman. I believe... Well, at first I thought it was a Sherman Firefly, so I knocked out some of his shit. Nope, it's just a Sherman. Sherman, probably M4A2, maybe. Actually, I don't know. Might be. But that second shot didn't penetrate, and now he knows I'm here. I try to shoot again. Nothing. But thankfully, he didn't penetrate either. But now we have a problem. Thankfully, though, somebody kills him. That gives me an assist. There's something else there. I shoot randomly through the tree. Could just barely make him out, and that shell penetrated, knocking him out. That puts me up on six kills and an assist. Watching for that Sherman Jumbo that was over there earlier. Still no sign of him just yet. We've got teammates capping the B zone. We still have A. Since then, my squad mate, he is still alive. I believe he's actually in the A point right now, just kind of shooting down. I'm assuming he's shooting down from the ridge. Looking for things, not noticing anything just yet, but I have to keep my eye on that Sherman Jumbo every now and then in case he comes out, because you never know when he might pop out of nowhere. Now, I haven't been keeping an eye on who I've been killing, but then there he is, and he's shooting at something. He kills something of ours that I believe just spawned in, so there you go. Get rid of not only two scumbaggery spawn camper, but also a Sherman Jumbo. Thankfully, his side armor was still pointed towards me, and I finished him off. And that puts me up on seven kills, and still that one assist. So I like this position for this reason, that you can do quite a bit up here, even with a tank like this, where the gun depression is pretty shit. Now this, I put a shot into this guy, knock out three of his crew members, and set him on fire. And I then wait. Of course, I'm not moving, because I want to shoot into him again. And then the shell somehow flies way the fuck off in a different direction and ricochets off of him. And I wait, I try to aim, shoot again. That one was a ricochet, and now you can see that he's moving, he's pulling back or something, I believe. So I'm not going to try and shoot at him anymore. And then we have, it looks like, another M4, maybe it's an M4 Sherman. Yeah, I think that's just a straight up M4. Could be an M4A2, either way, it's just a Sherman. He knows where I'm at. His shell dropped short. My first shell didn't penetrate. But my second shell does. And that gives me 8 kills. Now my squad mate was since knocked out, and he's now driving his SU-85. He drives below me, and he says into the chat, "You really like that spot, don't you?" And just as I was going to go and type, "Yes, yes I do," I get killed by a P-47. That then smashes into the ground. So, I mean, I can only assume that that was somebody that I had killed previously, because I hadn't damaged anybody who then died later and then came back. And I don't think there was really any squads on the enemy team, and if there was, they were already dead. So I can only imagine that that was somebody I killed that then knew where I was, spawned in his P-47, and came for me, and didn't care that he'd lose his aircraft, he just wanted to make sure I was dead. But remember, people, there are no suicide rocketeers in realistic battles. So I spawn into my SU-85. I'm up on 8 kills, an assist, and a death, so I'm doing pretty well so far, and the SU-85 is definitely a good vehicle. The gun on this thing is fantastic, although you do have that limited firing arc. Now, we've lost the A point, and I can hear things like a British SPAA firing, and I thought I heard some other SPAA heavy cannon firing, I believe. Yeah, right there, it was Crusader AA Mark I is also over there, which has just been set afire and is probably most likely going to be dead. So I'm heading right for it. And there goes a teammate, Chaika, with rockets, who is actually going to do more than you'd expect. He just killed somebody. Now, I did just shoot the front of that Crusader, knocked out one of his crew members, and he did just kill that T-34. That Crusader AA Mark II just killed that T-34 from the front. So now I'm being very cautious, knowing that he can apparently do that. We need to get into the A point, because now B is being decapped. And I said on the map that there's somebody over there, hoping that maybe that Chaika would go over there and kill that goddamn SPA, who is clearly more interested in killing tanks than shooting down planes. And I'm waiting, and he's not poking out, so I decide, screw it, let's push forward. We need to push forward. I really don't want to lose this match, because I was having a lot of fun. And there you go. He fired off a set of his rockets and killed the Crusader AA Mark II, which puts me up to a total of 8 kills and 3 assists, because I believe that M4A1 Sherman from earlier was killed as well, the one that I caught on fire. I get into the cap zone and start decapping and capping it, period. And instead of watching down the ridge, I make sure that nobody can shoot me from down there, and I start aiming off in this direction in case any enemies come to pursue me. Now, my crew was spotting something because my score was going up, and I didn't know if it was down there. See, you can see how I'm looking down there just in case. But no, there is something over there, and it's shooting at something of ours. It looks like a Sherman Firefly. So I immediately try to get into a better position in case my first shot screws up. He starts moving after his second shot. He can see me. But thankfully, the SU-85's 85mm gun is very good, and I didn't have to aim for any weak spots there. So that puts me up to 9 total kills, and I'm about to cap the zone. And there goes the zone cap. And there goes a plane. I believe that was ours, trying to bomb something. An M10, that's not going to last very long. Puts me up on a base capture, 10 kills, 3 assists, and 1 death so far. So we are now capping B back, and C is being capped by the enemy. So this match is pretty much going both ways every now and then. We got somewhat similar numbers, somewhat. We've got a little more. I'm being shot at by this Crusader now, another Crusader, completely different one, I believe, completely different one. I took out that other M10, that puts me up on 11 kills. And now we've got this Crusader. Thankfully, I didn't take any damage from him, but the moment he pokes out thinking he's got me, I put my shot through, and this time I do knock out the Crusader by knocking out all of his members in the turret. So I begin moving forward, and to the left of me, I can hear an engine sound. So I immediately start moving, and it's an Avenger. Now, I was going to... Now, he started to pull forward, and I was going to shoot the top part of his turret, but I wasn't sure if that was a good idea or not. What you're going to see isn't necessarily bullshit. Not at all. But it's something that I have to point out, because there are still people that exist that believe in this kind of bullshit. Now, the Avenger can fire only pure AP shells, as far as I am aware. and he's not even firing sable rounds or anything like that. However, the problem with this is that there has always been this group of people, this chunk of the community, that has always flagged and flacked my videos where I was either driving a vehicle and firing PAP, or I was being killed or shooting at a British vehicle or something like that. For example, when I was driving a British vehicle and I was shooting at an enemy SPAA, a German SPAA, and I had shot into him and knocked his ammo rack out, and he exploded, but it didn't give me the kill credit. There was a whole wide variety of people that said, idiot, you can't set off an ammo rack with PAP. But really, the true idiot are these people, because you very well can set off an ammo rack with PAP. And I do it all the time when I'm driving my British vehicles, and I have it done to me all the time. I don't know how people think PAP can't set off an ammo rack, but it can. So you can probably guess what's coming. Now, I was assuming, which is why I did this, I would have waited, but I was assuming that I'd be able to push up, since he has a high penetrating shell that is AP, I thought I could get him to shoot at the top part of my vehicle, which is what I was doing, so that he would shoot, and then I would quickly drive over and shoot him in the face. And you can see, the only thing he can see is the top part of my tank. But he shoots and knocks out my ammunition, which sets me off, and I explode into a million pieces. So, yeah, you can kill vehicles and set off their ammunition rack with PAP. Now, this is actually my squad mate here while I'm loading into the next tank. He is in his PE-2205. And I'm trying to decide what I want to drive next. So let's go ahead and switch back to player view here. So I have chosen to drive the KV-1E. So, just to recap, I'm on a base capture, 12 kills, 3 assists, and 2 deaths. And they are now decapping A. We have capped C and B. But A is being capped, and I can only imagine that it is that Avenger that just killed me previously. So I'm moving to intercept. Now, he has a high penetrating gun, and he can easily penetrate through my armor. But honestly, I really didn't care, because I'm in a KV-1, and KV-1s are almost like Sherman Jumbos, and they're a bit bullshit. So I really didn't care how I approached this guy, because I knew that no matter what he was going to do, as long as I was angled very slightly, I would have been able to do pretend you didn't see that notification in the bottom right corner of the screen there. I knew that no matter what I did, I was going to be able to take a hit. Even if I took damage, it was only going to be minimal damage. So instead of going around or flanking, I decide, screw it, I'm going to go straight up this hill. Because I can see they're capping A again. They stopped capping, then they started again. And so I just assumed, screw it. He's up, he's over there, I'm going to get this guy. Now I really didn't angle my armor too much here, as you can see. But there he is, and he's going to notice me right away. He turns his turret, shoots, I shoot, we both shoot. He knocks out one crew member of mine, but I knock out all of his shit. And there you go, they're not decapping anymore. I've gotten revenge. That puts me up to 13 total ground kills, and I'm about to move on the cap zone and take it back. Now, the enemy team only has roughly 4 players left, and of course, while we didn't know this during the match, you can see over there what they have. They have a Cromwell, an M4A1, and 2 SPAA vehicles. Now, they started decapping B, so the first thing I did was I started capping A, but then I decided to go over to try and shoot at B, and I can see they've done a lot of changing here. You can hardly see B anymore from this ridge, which it never used to be like. That must have been one of the other new additions they made when they changed over to the new version of the Ash River map that I hadn't noticed yet. I've got a friendly BT-5 here with me. My squadmate has since died in his aircraft, and I believe he's out of spawns. And I just capped another zone, and I'm going to start moving this direction. I think we've got this. They've only got 3 vehicles left. We have 5, and we are now capping B again. And that is going to bring this match to an end. And I'm going to finish the match with 2 base captures, 13 ground kills, 3 assists, and 2 total deaths. One, of course, to an aircraft, and as you know, I usually don't count aircraft deaths. So really, in tank-on-tank combat, I only died once to the Avenger, and took a bit of damage in my T-34 from some of the other vehicles. It was really fun to play this match, honestly. I don't know why, because I used to drive the T-34-57 1943 version quite a bit. It used to be one of my go-to vehicles. Of course, it was one of the premiums that was one of the earliest premiums on the Russian tech tree way back in the day, and I used to drive it all of the time. Of course, if you look at my kill-death ratio in realistic battles and things like that, you'll see it's kind of shitty. Well, that's because I was driving it back when I first started ground forces quite a bit. But it is pretty high compared to some of my other Russian vehicles, and that is also because I started driving it back in the day. But I love it. I love the T-34-57. I think it's got a great gun. And now that the battle ratings of the T-34-57 and the T-34-85 are a lot different to each other, that means there is more of a use to the T-34-57. Because back in the day, the T-34-57 Mod 1943, which is battle rating 4.7 compared to the default T-34-57, which is battle rating 4.3 for realistic battles, back in the day, the T-34-85s were roughly the same battle rating. There was one at 4.7 and then one at 5.0, and then I believe they went up to, one went up to 5.0 and then one went up to 5.3, and now they've gone up even more. I think the one at 5.0 has gone up to 5.3 and the one at 5.3 has gone up to 5.7 or something like that. So back in the day, there was always this talk about, well, what one's more useful to drive, the T-34-57 or the T-34-85? And I always liked the T-34-57 just because I really liked the gun on it. The gun is good. It's got good penetration, high velocity, and a good reload rate. Nowhere near as good as the 85mm, of course. But now that the 85s have gone so far up in battle rating compared to the 57, there is more of a use to driving it now, in my opinion. And I do still really like it. Of course, the SU-85 is another one of my favorite vehicles to drive in realistic battles. And the KV-1E, while I haven't driven it very much at all, it's a KV-1. What could you expect? Though it is battle rating 4.3, and we were in a match. We weren't in a 5.7 match. Some of the other matches we played today, we got up-tiered like shit. I was still fighting a lot of other tanks that, of course, were a little bit higher battle rating than 4.3. But by the time I started driving the KV-1E, all of those higher battle rating vehicles were out of the match for the most part. So it wasn't that bad. And I enjoyed the match. I had fun. I have fun usually when I play most of my matches, but this is a match that I thought was fun and high-paced to go ahead and share on the YouTubes. And I know people usually like to see my results screen. I unfortunately couldn't show you that, but I did write it down at the end of the match. I finished with a whopping 3,705 vehicle research, but that's because I'm driving tier 2s and 3s, tier 3 specifically, and trying to grind to tier 5, so that's why my RP reward there was really, really crap. But as for Silver Lions, I finished this match with 108,525 Silver Lions, and that was without a Silver Lion booster. That is crazy, in my opinion. Normally, earning Silver Lions in ground forces is really hard to do, but finishing an RB match like this with over 100,000 Silver Lions, that is crazy, and that's a major profit, so I'm extremely happy with that result. Anyways, guys, that's going to bring this one to an end. Feel free to post your comments in the description. Oh, shit. Feel free to post your thoughts on the comments section below about your thoughts on tanks like the KV-1E or the T-34-57 Mod 1943, things like that. Anyways, guys, we're going to go ahead and bring this one to an end. I do have a few others. While some of my IS-6 episodes were recorded a few days to a week ago, this one's going to go up in between to kind of give a little bit more variety, even though it is just a Russian tank. Anyways, thanks for watching.